Last time I had the audacity to criticize Blizzard's PvE game mode during the Uprising event, I spent a good bit of time during my intro explaining that their purpose is not to mindlessly hate on the game mode, but rather wanting it to improve because I felt it was a good foundation to build on. While I felt that the video reflected that message very well, people still decided to take personal offense and only heard what they wanted to hear. So we're going to skip that this time and just get right into why I think Blizzard absolutely done goofed this time. So the Overwatch Halloween Terror is back, and with it, Junkenstein's Revenge makes a return. Last year, when all of that launched for the first time, players were loving the idea of it because it was the very first time PvE content was introduced to the game, myself included. Naturally, criticism was a bit on the lower side because we all understood that this was a testbed for them. They were trying out how the player base felt about PvE content in an otherwise PvP-only game, and Uprising felt like they were taking that idea to the next level, giving us a more engaging PvE game that unfortunately retained some of the flaws from Junkenstein's Revenge. By now, I feel like the devs and I simply have different ideas for what makes a good seasonal game mode. To understand what I mean, I want to go back to the Summer Games event with Lucio Ball. The second iteration of Lucio Ball, while coming with very minor changes, largely retained a lot of the flaws its predecessor had and merely slapped a competitive game mode on top of it. The hit reg was wonky as all hell, the map remained very plain, and by that did not even take advantage of Lucio being the only hero in the game that can wall ride. Overall, it just felt very lazy. Now, if we take a look at the Halloween Terror event 2017 and compare that to the previous iteration of Junkenstein's Revenge in 2016, as well as the Uprising event with its own PvE game mode, it just feels very lazy again. Now, I very deliberately say feels lazy because I don't know how much work went into this, and we'll get a bit more in detail about this in a bit. Last time I made a video like this, my biggest point of critique was the lack of replayability. Going from the first Junkenstein's Revenge to Uprising, now back again to the 2017 version, that problem remains. The reason replayability is so important is because these game modes keep coming back. Right now, they only appeal to a very specific niche audience that loves achievement hunting or is really into the idea of playing the exact same content over and over again. And that is just another thing that feels lazy about it, the difficulty levels. I was playing through all of them with a group of friends, and honestly, it just wasn't engaging. Higher difficulty levels just turned out to be massive clusters of overwhelming amounts of enemies rather than genuinely difficult boss encounters. Rather than giving the bosses interesting phases, they just sent more of them. One Reaper is too easy to take out? Well, here have five! Now, a good example of repetitive content done right is Cuphead. While I have not played it myself, as I'm terrible at such games, I'm sure that you have heard of it by now given its popularity. The reason Cuphead works so well, even though you keep playing through the same content over and over again until you beat it, is because the content is genuinely engaging. The bosses are interesting, the environment changes, and there's a pinch of RNG for good measure. Cuphead is a phenomenal game that understands that you can't force players to keep repeating a boss fight with artificial levels of difficulty because they will get sick of it. And that is exactly the case here. In Junkenstein's Revenge, bosses on the higher difficulties hit like a freaking truck when you get too close. The AI is not behaving smartly at all, and there are no interesting phases to speak of either. You just have a bunch of bullet sponges in front of you that do the same annoying things over and over again until you eventually pumped enough damage into them to call it a day. The smartest thing I ever saw an NPC do was attack my turret when it was right next to it. I mean, for crying out loud, the summoner does not even try to keep her beam locked onto us, even on the highest difficulty level. And why would she? It would probably be an even more annoying enemy to oppose and probably be overpowered as hell. There are a set few things you do to play through it optimally, like taking out bosses via nano deadeye, bionading a healing Rotog, sleeping Junkrat on top, and pull molten core in literally every boss encounter because that ultimate forms itself in no time as long as your turret exists. Even when you have not played through the original last year, replayability absolutely goes down the drain, and I'm scared of the thought that this will come back year after year with one boss added respectively. The reason I'm so upset about this is because I know that Blizzard can do better, and it just feels like to me as a consumer that they are content with giving us this half-baked game mode because they are sure that we will eat it up anyway when a few tweaks and changes could have made it that much more engaging. While yes, there's a lot of baby rage going on in this video, and complaints regarding this are fully justified, I just don't think that we as a community should be okay with them doing this. Blizzard would not be where they are right now if they kept dropping their standards like this, and with the experience they have from last year's Junkenstein's Revenge as well as Uprising, there's just no excuse for them to not have done better. And all of that I say coming from a consumer's perspective, a frustrated one at that. Naturally, if I sit down in my role as a content creator and try to think twice as to why they did what they did, I guess I could squeeze some reasoning out of myself. yourself. Overwatch is not a PvE game. The core of the game remains in the traditional game modes, and this is where the bulk of their efforts should go. It could have been a staffing issue with developers being busy preparing new permanent content that they want to announce at BlizzCon, and they just had to make a decision here which ended up having to neglect this year's Halloween Terror Event. I mean, the reason I'm so upset with this gimmicky seasonal game mode is because ranked currently feels awful to me, so it would only be natural to expect and to sit down some more people to try and fix what is the core experience of the game rather than this limited time game mode. Obviously, not everyone will feel as strongly about this as me. I'm even fairly certain that most people probably won't care. It's just a shame to see something that could have otherwise been an awesome game mode turn out to be something so lazy and throwaway feeling. I really did not want the focus of today's video to be a number of fixes, because honestly, I'm not a game developer, I don't know what the resource allocation is looking like over at Blizzard, and I have no idea if they even care to begin with. There are a few ideas I would have that would add to the value of the game mode, but none of them are particularly creative, so I'll leave that to you guys down in the comment section below. Now here's hoping that BlizzCon impresses us ever the more in return. But this is me done for the day, so I needlessly complain about Junkenstein's Revenge. If you enjoyed the video, then do let me know by dropping me a like on your way out, leave all of your thoughts down in the comment section below, and if you want to keep the show going, consider supporting the channel directly by sponsoring me via YouTube Gaming for just $5 a month. It really does help out more than you know. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope to see you all next time.